गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास, वेलकम बैक आफ्टर हॉलीडेज। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट अवर रिमेनिंग टॉपिक, दैट वाज आई थिंक मैग्निफिकेशन। नाउ मैग्निफिकेशन इज डिफाइंड एज साइज ऑफ इमेज टू द साइज ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट इन केस ऑफ एनी ऑप्टिकल इंस्ट्रूमेंट, whether it be convex lens, concave lens, convex mirror, concave mirror, or any combination of all these, this thing is going to hold true. That is, magnification is defined as, first of all, it is represented by M, and it is defined as side of image to the size of object. Also, mathematically it can be written as V by U. V is distance of image from the mirror. In case of spherical mirror, V is distance of image from the mirror and U is distance of the object from the mirror. Now, many people take sign of these things. Some write it as minus V by U, V by U, real, virtual. But you don't have to be confused. Following all those things, all you have to remember is M is defined as V by U, and also analytically size of image for the size of object. And there can be many cases which you will learn again as we move along, but for now, suppose this is our object AB, and just take a ray parallel to the axis, it will go through focus. One that goes through focus will become parallel to the axis, and this is image, it has image. As we can see, this image is real, cause it is inverted. So our magnification is defined as size of image upon size of object. What is size of image? That is a dash b dash. Again, size of object is a b, and that is defined as also v by u, where v is image distance from the mirror, that is this one, upon object's distance from the mirror, that is this one, v by u. And I'll explain later how to use this formula while solving the question. So for now, what did it learn? That magnification is defined as V by. Now, very important thing while solving the question is sign convention. We have to take signs of these various distances such as u, v, focal length, radius, and these things change according to convention of different types. But the very famous one is, which you will follow, is first I am going to show you sign of focal length. Now, there are two types of mirror. One is convex, second is concave. What you have to remember is focal length for concave mirror is always taken negative. Then again, focal length for convex mirror is taken positive. Now you must remember this thing, this is not only change, that focal length for concave mirror is going to be negative by solving numerical. It is not negative, it is taken negative. Focal length for concave mirror is negative while solving numerical, and focal length for convex mirror is positive for numerical purposes, nothing else. you are not going to put any sign near me by you. For that you must remember where the image is formed in various cases, when the image is real, when the image is virtual, and so on, that you have done before. Now let's take a very basic example. Let me remind you all the things that we have done so far. For example, for concave mirror. First of all, focal length of concave mirror is negative. As we can see here, it is taken negative. Second thing, what kind of image convex mirror forms? Sorry, concave mirror forms. The answer is it forms both the both type of images, the real one too and virtual one. But in majority of the cases, image formed is real. It only forms virtual image in one case, that is when object is situated between pole and focus. It will look like this. When object is situated between pole and focus, in case of concave mirror, then image form will be virtual. And most important thing that you have to remember, that virtual image in case of mirror is formed on the opposite side of object. If object is located, for example in this case, object is located towards left of mirror. So our virtual image will be formed opposite side of object, that is right side of mirror. We are not talking about size of image or anything else. But what you must remember that if the image formed is virtual in case of concave mirror, then it's going to be located on opposite side of object. One more thing, focal length has to be taken negative, and of sign of U, that is object's distance from the mirror, must be taken negative also in case of concave mirror. So in case of concave mirror, two signs are trivial. One is sign of focal length must be negative, then again sign of U, that is object distance from the mirror, that is also negative. So for concave mirror, F and U both are negative. These things may look like very difficult things to remember, but once you get a hold of it, once you practice a lot of numerical, it will become quite easy. So for now, that you must know what you have to remember is sign of focal length and sign of U. U is object distance from the mirror must be negative. And for convex mirror, focal length is positive. Focal length is positive and U is negative. These two things you must remember. Sign of focal length for both the mirrors and sign of U. U is common for both the mirrors, that it must be negative, be it convex or concave mirror. And focal length for concave is negative, considered negative, and focal length for convex mirror is considered positive. Try to remember these things, try to mug it along, try to carve it in your mind, and we'll meet again tomorrow and we'll solve some numericals. Thank you.